Hi friends, today I am going to discuss the case note of Miss Arthur Hugo. Date of birth is given 26/10/88. So let's read the history before that. Today's date is mentioned 6/11/2007. So what is our position? You are a home health nurse working for a local maternity hospital. The patient, Arthur Hugo, a 19-year-old fast food restaurant manager, has returned home after giving birth at your hospital. You've been assisting for the past week under the patient's insurance policy, but will need to hand the patient over to a community nurse when this time is over. That is, means on the 8th postpartum day. So today is the 8th postpartum day, that is 6/11/2007. The occupation, again it's mentioned here, restaurant manager. What are the personal history? Separated from child's father. Recently moved to this area. Few friends live locally. That means few means nothing, no friends. Parents are unable to visit or offer help. Client works long hours during day, will be unable to care for baby during day when she goes back to work. Then recent medical history. 12-hour uncomplicated vaginal delivery, healthy baby boy. Then previous medical history is mentioned, no history of serious illness, injury or surgery. Then the postpartum progress. Client responded well to instruction in hospital, breastfeeding established successfully, concerned about caring for baby alone. That is her problem. Here also it's mentioned she will be unable to care for the baby during the day. Then the second postpartum day, she was discharged home. Fourth postpartum day, because we are the home health nurse, we are going at her home and taking care of the patient. Then patient coping poorly with adjustment. Then baby crying constantly, unable to sleep after arriving home, house untidy and disorganized. Then next day, patient disheveled, that means patient looked untidy and groomed like that. Then sobbing, crying, noisy. Then exhausted, he is burned out, already tired. Then seventh postpartum day, baby has stopped crying. Patient greatly relieved. Patient feeling guilty. Poor mother regrets decision to have child. Child looks pale and lethargic. Diarrhea, too sleepy to breastfeed. Buttocks excoriated. Skin dry. Patient weight. The child's weight has decreased since discharge. Then what is the nursing plan of the home nurse? Patient may need mental and emotional assessment by a mental health nurse and support with bonding and caring for her child. Child's weight and general health requires monitoring. Possible assistance required with household duties or chores. Most probably domiciliary care. They can provide a carer. So what is the writing task? Using the above notes, write a letter to Martha Villas Community Nursing Service about the patient. So we know the recipient is Martha Villas Community Nursing Service. That is the community nurse. So how we can write this letter? What all information we have to include? Should we write day by day? no need. So we can concise together and we can write. So the first we can write, Miss Martha Villas, community nursing service. Then the date, it's mentioned here, 6/11/2007. Then the salutation we can write like, dear nurse. But the name is given, so we can write, dear Miss Villas. Regarding the reference is who? Miss Arthur Hugo. The date of birth is given. Or the age is mentioned. We can write age 19. Whichever you want, you can write it. So what should be the introduction? You can write, because we are referring this patient to her. I am writing to refer or introduce. Or we can write the purpose of the letter is to introduce this Miss Hugh Arthur Hugo, who has coping difficulties post partum period, or you can write following her delivery. So she requires the assistance for caring of her, for her baby. Requires your assistance or support to take care of her baby, like that, or regarding baby care of the baby. Whatever you want, you can write. Then we can just provide a summary. This because it's mentioned here, it's already 8 postpartum days. So what we can write, Miss Hugo gave birth to her baby boy, or you can write he birth on 28 October through vaginal delivery, and her postpartum period was uneventful. However, she was concerned about caring for her baby alone. Then we can mention, because she was separated from the child's father, and she has recently moved to this area, and her parents are unable to offer help for her, and she is quite worried about upbringing of her baby due to her hectic work schedule. So they got idea why we are referring her. Then we can tell, as she was before that, we can mention that she was, her postpartum period was uneventful, and she was discharged home after 2 days. However, she is concerned about taking care of her baby alone because of these issues. Then we can tell, following her after being discharged home, or we can during my home visit after 2 days, patient had difficulty with taking care of baby, or you can coping. And she was unable to sleep because her baby was crying persistently. In addition, she looked ungroomed and was crying. And in addition, her house also was disorganized, disarranged. Or we can write like this, on subsequent days, she found difficulty for coping with this situation, and because her baby was crying persistently she was unable to sleep, which leads to her to become tired or exhausted, and that's why she looked ungroomed and was crying. Then we can mention, yesterday she found to be greatly relieved because her baby has stopped crying. However, she felt guilty for being a poor mother, and she even regrets the decision to have a child. With regards to the child, or you can write an assessment, her child looked pale, lethargic, and his skin was dry. Additionally, his buttocks was excoriated due to diarrhea. He was unable to breastfeed owing to excessive sleepiness. Of note, his weight has decreased since discharge. We mentioned everything. So just go to the recommendation. It would be greatly, no need to mention greatly nowadays, only we can write, it would be appreciated if you could send a nurse, or if you could provide support for her to develop a relationship between the mother and child, and assist her in taking care of her child or upbringing her child. She may need a mental and emotional assessment by a mental health nurse. Kindly, or we can please monitor child's weight and general health. Please monitor the child's weight and general health. Please or kindly arrange a carer for the domiciliary care because she lives alone. That's enough. Then we can write, please do not hesitate to contact me if you have any queries. As the name is mentioned, you can write to your sincerely home health nurse. I think it's clear for you. It's just an example. You can make it more clear, and in that way you can develop your own ideas. Thank you for supporting me and watching my channel. And if you have any, if you need any assistance, or you have some questions, you can just comment below the comment box. Thank you. Bye.